Hey YouTube, I'm back again. So I did a video for this last week. I just purchased this, unfortunately. I bought a base and I kind of need the money, so I'm going to buy another one of these later when I can afford it. I'll see if I can get one that's beat up or bits missing. So I'm just going to sell this on, unfortunately. But this is what I would be reckoning is the best guitar you could buy new just now for cheap. So there's another video I did of this where I was talking about it a bit more. This one's really just a demo. What I decided I was going to do, which I think I said I was going to do in the last video actually, I was going to put push-pull pots in to put coil splits into the pickups because I felt that that was really what the guitar was missing. Unfortunately, I got to the point, I've added the extra wires to the pickups, put the pots in. The pots don't fit in this guitar because it's too thin. So, well, I could have fitted them in, but it meant the volume controls were sitting up on stocks. So what I did instead was I stuck in a wee mini switch here. I can't reach it from here. Well, that's really difficult to do right there. So there's a wee three-way mini switch in there. I was going to make it just a coil split, you know, to split both of them. But I like this switch, which I've never seen before. I might have invented. I stuck it in a Les Paul a while ago. It's a coil choice. So if you pull it up, so the humbucker. Pull it up, you get a single coil, which is, I will tell you, this is how you test whether a pickup's working, inner coils, right? So if you pull it up, you get inner coils. The reason I like this switch is, the problem I have, and the other reason I like the push-pull pots is, if you leave them pushed in, you never know they're there, so you always know they're off. Whereas if you just get a two-way switch, you don't know until you play it whether it's on, you know, humbucker mode or single coil mode. Whereas with a three-way switch, if you've got it in the middle, it's in humbucker mode. Up is inner coils, down is outer coils. So you get, there's your, so go for the neck pickup. I've also moved this switch so it now, that way's neck and that way's bridge, rather than it being at a funny angle that it was before. And I turned around this guitar doesn't have the original string trees on it, it's got these roller ones. So I made them both the right way around. It really did my head in, I don't know. Everyone always says they're OCD. I don't think I am, but that annoyed me, the fact that one was going one way and one was going the other. Didn't make any difference how it worked. Just looked funny. Yeah. So there's your neck pickup and played through the Relaney VC15. No pedals. If I pull it up, we get this coil. Down, you get this coil. Sound a bit different. They're not, it's not a massive difference between the inner and the outer coil thing. On the neck pickup, I think it will probably make a bigger difference on the bridge pickup though. So here's the bridge pickup as a humbucker. Inner coil. Outer coil. Yeah, see, that's what I thought would happen. So if you're on the outer coil, that's very close to the bridge, and on a single coil that makes it pretty thin, sharp, as opposed to, it's a bit more usable. But when you're using the super thin mode and stop on a fuzz pedal, it really kicks ass. Inner coil. See, isn't this not as good when you're using the fuzz pedal? Then humbucker. I'm really thinking of late single coil. Fuzz pedals want single coils, and they want the thinnest single coil you can get, so that's pretty good. So, yeah, the bigger difference I feel is more in the, when you've got both pickups on. That's where you get the joy of the sort of dual sonic. So here they are, both as humbuckers. Outer coils. See? Inner coils. Bigger difference there. So my opinion, we'll play through a clean amp anyway, obviously it depends what it is you're doing with it, but my opinion would be in the middle position, you get two extra really usable sounds. You get your inner and outer coils are both brilliant and different enough to be usable. In the neck position, there's not a massive difference between the two. You can kind of take it or leave it, whether you want the inner coil or the outer coil, doesn't make that much difference. But in the bridge position, you get the outer one is a bit thin for clean playing. But loves, the fuzz loves it, whereas the outer coil is a bit, is a, the inner coil is a bit, have I got them the right way round? Yes I do. So the inner coils are much more usable, clean. So I've got some noise. I've just got myself a new pedal. I've got a new, couple of new pedals the other day. This is an overdrive from, it's a Tom's line, so I don't think it's expensive. I bought a pile of pedals off a guy on a Facebook page the other day. I haven't actually got a chance to play them all, but I was playing with this last night. It's a vintage overdrive, which he said was like a tube screamer, with Michelangelo Battio, you know, the guy who plays the two guitars like this. A picture of him on it, it's his signature one. So I'm quite liking it. I think I've always said, whenever I say I'm stamping on the tube screamer now, I've been stamping on the Zach Wild MXR pedal, which I was led to believe was a tube screamer. I don't think it was. I think it's a Boss DS1 or something like that. It's a slightly different circuit, so it's not really that much like this one. I keep bending the strings on this because I've been playing a 5-string bass the last couple of days. This is very small compared, and it's like, you're so used to just going, ah, you're holding the strings in. See, it's quite a subtle pedal, which I really like. You can still get to hear the guitar rather than it just being my usual just use the rat pedal and kind of all the guitars. Makes guitars all sound the same. This just gives you a bit more character. There's a difference in the neck pickup changing between which coil. Yeah, so these are still the original pickups in it. I thought they sounded pretty good as humbuckers anyway, but the single coil thing really brought them alive. It kind of makes the guitar sound more like what it looks. Back to humbucker mode. Single. Yeah, lovely. So what I said I was going to do last time was seeing as this is a beginner's mod, I've actually got a wee amp there I could throw in when I'm selling it. We're not very much more a Carlsbro kickstart. If you look, type that into the search in my channel, you'll see I did a review of that a couple of weeks ago. A decent wee 10 watt amp. But I would guess I would say old fashioned. You know, nowadays everyone uses a phone and all these things. But if you're going to buy an original amp, I would play through this wee Blackstar Fly 3-bot with no pedals on it, just because I feel a wee bit cheating. You know, I'm sitting here playing a £120 guitar, new, through a £400 amp. So it's not really what most people will have. Because I'd imagine most people will have, oh, I've had this problem before, but a stupid bendy lead. I'm worried about pulling the amp off the top of it. Right, so what did I was doing this? Where's the on button? There, right. Right, we're on. With no setup at all, so. It's got a distortion channel on. Probably a good start. Clean. Pretty much. Good. Kind of use delay really softly, it sounds like reverb. Thank you. again, that wee thing impresses me, because so does this guitar. Really, when you're, if you're learning to play the guitar, I started off on a, it was an old Honor Rockwood that was, it didn't play below the first three frets, and I still managed to learn to play guitar. I just played Black Sabbath up here, something wrong with the neck, even though I didn't know at the time. So if you're going to buy a beginner guitar, I mean, I would just definitely buy this. You could buy this one off me, so it's not going to be that much cheaper than a new one, but it does have the switch on it. I paid 80 quid for it, which I know is a lot, because these things are only 115, 120 quid new, but that's what they seem to go for. I've not seen a cheap one, that's why I've not bought one in the last year. Even if I saw one at 60 quid, I would have snapped it up, but it just doesn't happen. But the extra sounds, so it's got, instead of having three sounds, it's got, well, it's got three different sounds in each position. It's got nine, yeah. And I would say all nine of them are usable. Well, maybe the switch in between these two is not that much. So eight and a half really usable sounds that are all different enough to be mentioned. And again, the wee Blackstar amp. I fill it a wee bit with this amp because you don't get a power supply with it. It runs on your, well, this is actually running on little batteries, which I think are about £1 for a set, and they seem to last for ages. I mean, these ones actually, they weren't new, but I bought them new, obviously, when I bought them new, but I had them in this, I was messed about with this. I put them in the wee Joyo bass app, took it to download, played through that. I've used it a few times in that, and then I put them back into this, and they're still going. The batteries that came in this when I got it in China lasted 6 months. It's like, well, I wasn't playing it every day, obviously. But apart from the fact you don't get a power supply, and it's got its own stupid connector thing on it. Why does it... I don't understand how that works. It says it runs on 6.5 volts DC, which you don't get... If you're using 6 1.5 volt batteries, that adds up to 9. So I don't know how it's a 6.5 volt power supply. But I think they've done that so that you have to buy their official Blackstar power supply, which I think is either 12 quid or 20 quid or 25 quid. Whatever it is, it's annoying. Because you just think, why don't you just make it so you can run it off your cheapy Boss type power supply? But obviously, there's probably some reason for it. So if you're starting off, I would buy, thinking about maybe, oh, maybe give guitar a go, I would buy this, because this is all you would need as an amp. Okay, you can't play gigs with it, obviously, but I mean, sound-wise, that's totally fine. I would be totally happy with that if that was all you had to start with. It does the clean, as you heard. It does the distortion without any pedals in that, so you just need that. Buy one of these. And then you're still, these are like, so 120, these are about 60 quid, I think, if you buy a new one, something like that. So that gives you like 20 quid to buy like a strap and, you know, some plectrums and a case, maybe. That would be all you'd need. Perhaps one of those wee clip-on tuners that's you totally set with a brilliant setup for learning. It's like, if you get, like, if you just buy a shit guitar, just, I'll have a shot at playing the guitar, and you just buy, like a crappy Strat or something off Gumtree or eBay, you know, for sort of under 50 quid, it might not work. You might be lucky. I've bought them before where you go, oh, this is a really good guitar, and it was only like 40 quid. But most of the time, because I've had half an hour fiddling with it, but most of the time there's something missing or something not right about it. You know, so many times it's just, even if it's just like, you know, like a tuner missing or like a saddle or something, or just need to set up to play well. I mean, this one does play well. Like I said, my only problem is with it just now is because I've been playing the big fat bass strings all day yesterday, going onto a guitar. I'm holding the strings down too hard, so they're bending too much. I need to... I'm getting better the more through the video we go. Like I said, that wasn't really a very, very fast, I'm going to sell this guitar really cheap video. So there we go. So that, I'm going to sell that to try and fund, well, to make up for the fact that I bought that when I couldn't afford it. But rock on.